Hello, everybody.
How's it going?
Welcome to another wonderful Thursday afternoon. We are here at the game show headquarters, and we are going to be playing some Call of Duty.
Call of Duty Black Ops. I think this is 3, right?
3, man. The brand new one. The brand new one with all the funny colors. The guy who's always constantly cracking his neck.
He always does that. Yeah, we've been staring at that for a minute.
We're watching it right now, and he's always cracking his neck. But we're going to be talking about 1.3 Beta 2.
Yeah. The second
1.3 beta. We didn't quite get YouTube chat in there, so now you have YouTube and Twitch chat capabilities.
Yeah, so YouTube's chat for their streaming platform now, we have the ability to bring in the messages for that.
So you can now stream to both and talk to people on both sides at the same time, so that's really exciting. And we also have the template export and sharing. We have a couple up there right now. We'll be going through that later to show you exactly the process of pulling a template down from the website and how to get it into Game Show and how you can start using those templates.
Yeah.
And I want to encourage you guys to start creating those templates too. So whenever we get some cool ones up there, we'll highlight you on the show, bring it in. Maybe you want to use one of your templates if you guys want to try and make one for us. I know there's some pretty popular games. Now that the year's closing out, taking a look back on 2015, some of the games that were really awesome. So,
yeah. So right now, I think we're just gonna play some video games for a minute.
Dude, I'm
let
so
some
ready.
People hang out.
I'm so ready.
Come on in. So,
Freiberg, heya! Just saw you. Just responded to you on Twitter. Yeah, if you're having problems downloading and installing, it's a little hard for us to troubleshoot that right here on Twitch. But we got people in the forums that understand what's going on there and can help you out. So they'll do some cool stuff for you. And then Sparkle Badass says hello. Silent Sentry says /. And let's get to this, man. I'm ready.
Sounds good.
Have you guys been playing Black Ops 3? I've heard some kind of like...
Well, let's switch over to
yeah, I'll let you do that.
Black
I've heard
Ops
some iffy and... things about it. There's like issues with some split screen, and the zombies is a little bit different than it was in Black Ops 2, which I've played a lot in the Black Ops 2, but we try to do it here, and it's like a completely different world.
Yeah.
But I've enjoyed it so far. I don't know. All right, well, let's see what we can do here. Set up this game for
us. We're going to... Well, I did do a little bit setup stuff already, so
okay.
I think we're actually good to go. The thing I noticed that's weird about this game is when it goes into split screen mode, it like changes, it doesn't display full screen.
Yeah, it changes like the aspect ratio. Yeah, it makes it a little bit tight on the sides for some reason.
Yeah, so it'll look like it's all cut off on the sides. So we made like a little...
Capture the flag. Are we playing one-on-one right now? You're going
to
kill
no,
me.
No, there's supposed to be teams going on.
I sure hope so. Let's see, otherwise you're just going to absolutely slaughter me.
Yeah. See, that's what I was talking about. See how it cuts off on the side there? So we got a little thing right here.
Yeah. All right.
I don't know if we're on the same team or not.
No, we're not.
Capture the enemy flag.
All right.
This must be my flag.
Yeah. Whoa, that means we're on opposite teams.
Yeah, we are. Most definitely on opposite teams. Just to let you guys know, this guy's way better than me. These kind of games here.
I think we're both going to get each other's flags.
And there's no one else in these games.
I could have sworn that I put in for like four extra bots.
Where are you?
Where am I?
Yeah.
I gotta kill you over here.
Can't hear us?
Someone just told us that our audio is down,
but I can hear myself.
Tell me to check the audio.
we have double audio.
Uh-oh.
Sorry about that, guys.
We have a brand new microphone that we're using today.
And trying to make sure that it works out nicely.
We've been using a boom mic lately, but it's a little bit too sensitive.
No, I know what's going on here.
We can't go shoot me and stuff, man.
There's the problem right there. Look at that. Thanks, Silent Sentry and Sparkle Badass. Yeah, our camera had double audio in it. Or we had our camera's audio in addition to our microphone.
Rainbow Six. So how is Rainbow Six different from this game? I haven't been able to play Rainbow Six yet. It seems, at least from the commercials I see on Twitch on a regular basis, it says you gotta be a little more tactical or something,
or you have to have brains in order to play. Which I guess insinuates you don't have to be smart to play Call of Duty, but I'm not sure if that's really the case.
Yeah, I don't know. Call of Duty's pretty straight up.
Yeah, it's pretty straightforward, but I remember Rainbow Six, Tom Clancy, one of the original ones on Xbox, where it was all about, like, being stealthy and moving real slow. I was really good at that game. That got me into the Rainbow Six setup. Did you ever play that game?
Rainbow Six?
Yeah.
I did not, actually.
Oh, man, come on. You're just right there, and I just watched you. Come on. Come on.
Do I have your flag? How do I know? Oh, I do. Ah, ha, ha.
I have to go grab yours.
Not if I get there first.
Is this timed?
I don't know.
Come on, you should know these kind of things.
You know, I'm not a big Black Ops person, so...
You know what I found really weird is the coloring. The coloring on this is almost like... It's like too happy. When you're going around killing people, you don't want to be like bubbling in nice pastel oranges and stuff.
Why not?
Oh, it seems a little weird, doesn't it? Oh, look out. Look out. I see your shadow.
Did you throw a grenade at me?
Yeah.
Can I throw a grenade? Oh, like that?
Damn. Ask a question. I'm having trouble installing the app. Freiberg, yeah, ask us a question, man. I'll do my best. I mean, it's hard for us to fully troubleshoot exactly what's going on in your app when I'm playing a video game and streaming on Twitch. But I would love to hear what kind of issues you're running into, because it might be just a simple thing we can fix.
Definitely.
So let us know. And then there was another question. Hey guys, so after familiarizing myself with Game Show a little more, I wanted to ask a question. Is it possible to stream one shot, but record a separate shot simultaneously?
Yeah. So...
Or do I need to open a second instance of Game Show?
Well, so that's the thing. You don't have to open up a second instance. I mean, essentially it is. A separate document is the way to go. You just go File, New, and open up a new document and only include your source for what you want to record. So that's the way to do it for now.
Well, I just enabled overdrive and I'm going super fast. Whoa.
I need to find my flag.
Here it is. I got it.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, I can feel you following me, man.
Okay, I have your flag. You didn't need to go all the way back there.
Aren't I supposed to, like, what do I...
You have to have your flag at your base when you return mine.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
Capture the flag, man. Oh.
Here's my flag.
Okay, well, when I run the installer, it says I need the .NET 3.5 framework. If I recall correctly, 3.5 is separate from 4.6, and you actually have to have both installed? Don't quote me on that, although it is being streamed and recorded.
I think I just beat you.
The best way to add that is to go into your programs and features. In Windows, and then if you go on the left to add or remove Windows features, there'll be a checkbox once that finished loading for the checking the 3.5 framework. It's a lot easier than trying to like Google search it, find the right package. So definitely do that.
What is exactly for those people who don't know, including myself, what is exactly missing there?
It's like a runtime for that allows you to run code that's made in that. Oh, you killed me.
Dude, I'm so good at this game.
So yeah, you need that for... It's mostly for our support assistant stuff.
Oh, okay.
And yeah.
Get there, got the flag.
Silent Sentry, yes. I was talking about that today, actually. I still don't know the plausibility of that, but I think that would be great if we could do that, because it would ease a lot of people's transition.
What are we trying to do?
OBS or XSplit transfer.
Oh, yeah. We were talking about that the other day. Ooh. Seems like a pretty good idea. Oh, come back here.
I just waited for you to come in there.
Transfer setting from, oh yeah, function, or is that complicated? It might be complicated, but that doesn't mean it's not worth looking into.
Yeah. So it really depends on the format of how they store that information, which I have not looked into. So I don't know whether it's so plausible.
Oh, big news, by the way, guys. This guy sitting right next to me here, well, right above me, Bryce, my buddy Bryce, is the brand new game show product manager. What is it called exactly?
The associate project manager, yeah.
And so now, guys, you got the inside scoop on all things game show because you got product manager and the evangelist here. So we're kind of taking it under our wing and doing our best. We got some other people working with us, but when you talk to us, you're talking to the top. We are in the meetings deciding the future of game show. So if you guys have any suggestions, if you tell us, we're going to do our best to make it happen.
Yep.
So please, congratulate this guy right here.
Thank you.
Pretty awesome for him.
Now, congratulate me on getting your flag. You took my flag.
Hell yeah, I took your flag. What do you think?
All right.
Think I'm just going to let you win?
Yeah, you should. I already got your flag.
You just got a job, man. You don't need to win this game. Come on. Manually Google the download link. Discouraging to new users. Yeah, so 3.5 is what it needed, but 4 is the current one.
So if I'm not 100% sure on this, the issue with .NET frameworks is you need both, not like the most up-to-date version. It's like you need multiple libraries installed of different versions, not just the newest. They're different. Maybe mistaken, though. Wouldn't be the first time.
No.
And that means I'm gonna get your flag, or back to mine again. Yes.
Oh, at least I got the first round.
Thank
even though you were
Melissa,
trying to fix the
what, how do you say that? Melissa KIA04. Aha. Thank you.
KIA04?
Well, another monitor was in the way, so I couldn't really quite read all the letters.
Yeah, I was going to say, how did you not die right there? Come on.
Because it's Call of Duty.
No, if we were playing Counter-Strike, I would have been rocked, though. Useful to link a download directly from the game show installation window.
Agreed.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea too.
Either that, or find a way to link internally into the add remove programs window, which allows you to just click it. Or maybe we can automate it. I don't know.
Oh no! I had no bullets.
I will definitely see if we can ease that installation process, though.
Come on. I was playing some more Battlefield. Ooh, anybody going to see Star Wars tomorrow?
Ooh, we are.
We are. Hell yeah. I was playing more Battlefield yesterday.
Ooh, look at that. Wow. Does that say 3 and 0?
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm pretty sure that says 3 and 0.
I forgot how to read. I don't know what you're talking about. Whoa, watch yourself. Yeah, we're going to see the whole bunch of us. We're carpooling from here, from work down to Sacramento, and we're going to go see it. Is it in 3D?
It's in IMAX. I don't know if it's 3D or not.
I kind of hope it's not 3D because 3D makes me a little bit sick.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know. It's just kind of like...
the best thing ever?
Too much of that, you know?
Well, yeah, I guess. I like 3D movies, so... I didn't get a 3D TV, though. I thought it was a little too much for in the house.
Well, I mean, didn't that kind of just fail anyways?
Yeah, probably. Ooh!
What is going on? Come on.
Gotta aim better, man.
Yeah, that's probably my biggest deal with these kind of like first-person shooters. That I've always been bad at aiming. I guess I don't have... I think I just get too excited and I start twitching a little bit. You know what I mean?
You're twitching while broadcasting to Twitch.
Yeah, twitching on Twitch is what I'm doing. And it's a little bit frustrating, to tell you the truth.
I see where you went. Oh, there he is. I'm gonna get you.
Don't even say that kind of stuff.
I'm gonna get you. You ready?
No. I don't know where you are.
I know where you are.
I don't have any idea. There you are. Oh, get out of the way. Go. Where is he?
Oh, you got
yes.
me.
Yes, that's right. Got my flag. Get over there and get a point. Come on. Get there. Come on.
Nope. Oh, you're going to do it, aren't you? You're going to score. Better.
If it doesn't allow me to, I'm screwed. There we go. There we go.
You had to get 1 point, right?
Yeah. I did have to get 1 point. Whew.
Yeah, Silent Sentry. I mean, I'll see what we can do about that. It would be great to get at least ease that in some way, whether it's a link or we can make it even easier or package it with it.
Mm-hmm.
Something. Yeah.
Silent Sentry. Oh, it looks like we just got retweeted by Silent Sentry. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, or appreciate ma'am. It.
I apologize. Thank you, viewer. we actually got to go down to Twitch yesterday.
Yep.
That was pretty cool. We were on the inside, guys, seeing how everything works. Everyone was wearing their Twitch sweatshirts, which is really cool.
Dude, you're getting a little better there, huh?
Yeah, man. I played all day, you know. But we got to go inside. They gave me a free box of water.
A box of water?
Yeah, because boxed water is better, according to them.
Okay.
Which actually makes sense. I mean, instead of using plastic, you're using recycled paper. Which is pretty cool. And met with a guy who was really nice. We got to see how they game over there. They've got a killer setup, man. Oh, no. Yes.
Man. Don't Dude, even you're ask coming me. Back.
Yeah, I'm good at this game all of a sudden, huh?
Yeah. You finally learned how to aim, I guess. I don't know.
Well, it was all your snack talking, man.
I motivated you.
Exactly. Good, yeah. Uh-oh.
Final kill. See, you got that headshot. That's why.
See, whoa, did you see aiming. Your head explode?
Yeah.
Dude, this is violent. Guys, we were just looking up... Well, I guess actually this made me take a second to do this.
That's funny.
So this is not quite our last show of the year.
Wait, hold on. Silent Sentry, we didn't see any puppies.
Oh, that's not true, dude. I saw
one. You saw puppies?
Yeah, man.
What?
I didn't see like a puppy room, but I definitely saw a puppy walk by. Did you not even see?
No.
Weren't you the one who was like, look, a puppy?
I don't think so.
Oh, well, I remembered it. Anyways, we did see a puppy walk by. I'm not sure if it was...
A puppy room, though?
Yeah, I don't know about a puppy room.
Yeah, I don't know.
But definitely saw a puppy, which was pretty cool.
Yeah, okay, sorry.
But yeah, what we were going to say is that this is almost our last show of the year. We're not going to be here next week, by the way. It's Christmas Eve. Wherever you guys are in the world, it is holiday season here, and so we're going to be off work. We won't be around.
Yep.
But we will be back the next weekend, but Bryce won't be here.
Yeah, I will not be. We're going to have a guest streamer.
Yeah, a guest streamer. One of our co-workers here, his name's Andrew Grove. Mm-hmm. And so he's going to be jumping in. At least that's the plan for now. But that's going to be like New Year's Eve day. So this is more or less our last show of the year. And we just wanted to talk about kind of the year in gaming, the last year. Because for me personally, there was a couple games that I saw that were kind of outside the realm of what I thought games, the directions I thought games were going in. I actually just read about one of them. One of the ones that I'm talking about is Rocket League.
Yeah, I actually really like that game. I ended up buying it. I like it a lot.
Yeah,
it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, millions and millions of dollars. And it's an independent game. These guys, I don't know the exact story behind it. These guys made this super simple game where your RC car is playing soccer.
Yeah.
And they just crushed, man. It's like one of the top viewed things on Twitch on a regular basis. And they won at the Game Awards 2015.
Did they?
Excuse
I
me,
did
yeah.
Not, I did not hear that.
I see it right here. Best independent game. It was up against Her Story, Undertale, Ori and the Blind Forest. I haven't heard of any of these games.
No.
And Axiom Verge. And then, of course, Rocket League, which has just like dominated everything. And then the second game that really blew me away was Agario.
Agario is so much fun. I have that on my phone. It's pretty cool.
Wait, could we play Agario right now?
Yeah, we can. I mean, I can get it set up.
Do it. Yeah. If you guys have never played Agario, it is the most ridiculously simple and fun game that I've played in a long time. You are a little blob of color evading other blobs of color being played by other people online. And the goal is to envelop them and grow larger. So, oh yeah. See if you can get this up here. So Bryce is setting it up in the background, but if you go agar.io, it's an in-browser game. Super easy to get to. It's free. You can play right now, and it'll have thousands and thousands of people playing and watching people play it at any given time, which is just too funny. It's so much fun. Silent Sentry says, I was wondering if you guys plan on adding support for 1440p or 2560 by 1600. I use a 1440p capture card, but Game Show only went up to 1080 for the preview. Of course, I downscale to 2720p for the stream.
Mm-hmm. So, did you want to be able to record in that? Was that the goal, or just to show it in preview? Because if you're not going to record or stream with it, it's just it's really just taking up more resources.
So, it's possible, but if you could clarify exactly why you wanted to use it so we can have some idea of where we would go with it. You able to find this Agario here?
Oh, yeah. We just got so many monitors going on here. I'm trying to find it from the list.
There we go.
And then I'll do that, and then we'll just throw us on top of it.
Yeah, just throw a quick video. So we're just making this on the fly, so it's not nearly as polished as our other scenes.
You know what I should be doing, right, is go like that, and then... I want to go like that.
Send that live?
And then...
Okay, now you guys are looking at us inside Game Show. CPU's cranked up.
Yep.
There we go.
I think running this many monitors was not the way to go.
Yeah. When you guys stream, how many monitors do you have? You want to know how many we've got right now? Four.
Yep.
We've got our game up there. We've got Game Show here in the middle. We've got my monitor over here where I can do some things. His monitor over there where we actually have Agario up right now. And then I have my computer here, and he has his computer there. We're out of control. There we go.
We're way too big for that, yeah.
Nice, drop us down. And then...
You know what I need to do? If I go back over here... Oh,
okay. You're good. We're still here. Now you guys can see the behind-the-scenes action.
Move that over there.
Mm-hmm.
Move our picture down.
Beautiful.
Down here. And then we'll add like our cool little background that we got. Media file.
Nice.
What was the background?
Here you go, guys. This is the how the stream. Now we got the little Game Show coolness behind us here. And Agario.
Yeah.
Three usually. Silent Sentry, what do you put on those three? Because right now we have music, random, game show, game. Yeah, that's more or less right.
Yeah, game show, game. I usually have chat pulled up here.
Chat,
but I guess I don't need that since I got the laptop.
I'm going to send this live. Let's play.
Oh, yeah, do it.
You want to go?
Sure.
Yes.
Guest.
Here.
There you are.
Go.
It's all the mouse. Just move the mouse around.
Look out for Fish Boy. I've never been in the top spot before.
Yeah.
Audio?
Did you forget to put audio?
No, we should have audio.
Sounds like audio.
Here, let me check mine.
Looks like audio. Oh, you know what I did again? I know what I did again.
You did the double audio?
Yeah. You gotta get like this. My bad. We just need to like mute that. There we go. Look at that.
Come on, Bryce.
Yeah. I know what I did again. Is that better, guys?
I'm not sure. No, not better.
Take this off.
Oh, I know.
So many audio sources. I never sent it live.
Did you send it live now?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. There we go, guys. Apologize for that technical difficulty on the audio front. So one of the things that happens when you have all of these sources within your game is that it gets to be super complicated. And what we just did right there was on the fly, we added a brand new shot. And because we have our audio here, you can see it. Oh, you can't quite. It's a little bit too tight. But we have a microphone right there.
And that's in a different layer, so it's always on.
Yeah, so it's always on, so we can switch between shots on top. without losing our audio. But what happened was when we added a brand new camera selection, we still had our audio on there. We forgot
from
to take
the camera,
it off.
Yeah.
From the camera itself. It was kind of like the good quality audio from our microphone and then the bad quality audio from our camera that was kind of clashing. So if you use spacebar, you can shoot out.
Oh, I don't want to do that.
Yeah, well, careful. But now you can get right there. Oof.
You press the space and nothing happened. That's terrible.
That is terrible. There you go. Oh, but now you're two pieces and everyone's going to eat you. Oh, you got to be tactical about it. Jeb, 20 never, huh?
That's just $19.99 plus shipping. That's that guy's name.
Shipping and handling?
Yeah.
Speaking of monitors, I run my side monitors in portrait mode. Ooh, I've seen that before.
That's a great idea.
Yeah. It's a 1080p monitor, but Game Show wouldn't fit in that resolution.
Yeah.
I had to keep dragging it left and right to access the entire window, which would be useful if there was a portrait-friendly size option.
Yeah, I know with Game Show, we have, like, there's a minimum width that we have to fit both the previews in a usable fashion, or the preview and live out in a usable fashion.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of hard-coded at a minimum resolution.
Where'd everybody go? Oh, they're creeping down
from
the side.
I'm just trying to get all these things right here before I go back to go get some more.
Yeah. I've never been to the top slot before. It's like almost impossible. And don't hit those green guys.
Yeah, I know. They just put you into a million little...
Yeah, little pieces. They just crush you.
It's like...
Who's that little dude coming in and buzzing you?
He just started.
I love it.
What's, I don't have any
no me coma. That means don't eat me, man.
Don't eat me? That's what that means?
Yeah. Don't eat me, guys. I'm trying to win. So yeah, going back to... This is one of the other games. So this... Like this... I remember when I started... there was a certain streamer that I started watching a lot for Magic the Gathering Online. His name's Kenji.
Mm-hmm.
New Mott the Nummy. He's pretty rad. He, in between rounds with Magic, whoa, look at that thing.
I'm trying to get this guy, but he's running.
He might be a little bit too small for you to get.
Or big.
Yeah, sorry, excuse me, not small enough. But he would in between rounds just play this for like hours at a time. Ooh. Oh, the guy just exploded into you. Gout, dude, you're going to get crushed
know,
by that
I
guy.
I know.
But I got into this and I started playing this pretty religiously. It was a lot of fun. I'd go home, sit down on the couch, and just move my mouse around for hours at a time.
I'm all like, don't get eaten.
It's a stressful game, man. It is a stressful game. Okay, so we got a question here from Game Speaker.
Yeah.
Having an issue where screen capture is not working with the 1.3 beta. Screen shows the top of an IE browser, Internet Explorer, but not the content. Any options?
You know, I've never, ever, ever tried to capture Internet Explorer.
Yeah, Internet Explorer.
Exploder.
I don't want to just go out there and say it, but Internet Explorer could be the issue. Because right now, if I was to test with the... I'm running the 1.3 beta on my personal computer here. While Bryce tries not to die.
Yeah, I've only ever tried to capture Chrome or Firefox, and it's always worked.
Yeah, so what you're looking at right now, this Agario here, this is
Chrome.
In Chrome, and it's a Explorer capture.
So it's window capture.
Excuse me, window capture, not Explorer capture. So I'm not sure exactly how easy it would be for us to diagnose that problem right now. But
I don't even think... I think I uninstalled Internet Explorer.
Yeah, I don't have it on mine either, unfortunately. So we'd have to do a little bit of testing on our side before we know exactly what's going on there. But have you had issues with other internet browsers, Game Speaker? Maybe try Chrome. That's my favorite. Firefox is decent. I heard they just went to 30 or 64-bit for the first time.
Really?
Yep. Oh, Jesus Freak is a little guy now. He was like in fourth place a minute ago.
He got eaten, huh?
Yeah. Go get Jupiter. That's super cool. How'd they customize their skin like that?
I don't know.
I can get on board.
Whoa, don't go that way.
Ooh. Oh, that guy just exploded.
Oh, yes.
He's getting worked.
Out.
Oh, you're going to just pick it all up. Nice.
At least I got the bigger one.
Nice, nice, nice.
One thing I've never understood is how you get like to merge back together when you're a bunch of little ones. You gotta go find a corner?
Yeah, I don't know exactly how that works. I haven't been able to figure it out either. You haven't tried yet, you will. Yeah, I would recommend it. Oh, just to let you guys know, we are going to be giving away another 3 months at the end of the show today.
That is true.
If you haven't tried Game Show, you can download it now. www.gameshow.net. Mm-hmm. And you get a free 2 month trial at the moment. And if you win today, that'll be 5 months free of Game Show. And people are starting to get really excited about it. We've been releasing consistent new updates that are getting people pretty excited. Go get some Angel Pro tokens or whatever those are called. Yes, thank you, Angel Pro. Yes, what is he doing?
He's gonna die in a second. He's gonna break up into a bunch more.
Watch out for Big Green. Watch out for Big Green. Look at that, you're in the top 10.
Oh, look at that.
Hey.
I've never been up there.
Me neither, man. It's the beginning of a new era. Always winning. Oh, watch out for Press W, please.
Nah, I'm not worried about him. I'm worried about Red Guy.
Oh, he's big. Look out for Jumanji.
Ooh.
Enjoy the software, so awesome. Thanks, Game Speaker. Yeah, we enjoy it, too. It's a lot of fun. We, as you can tell, we are
having fun.
I was going to say that we are trying to do things on the fly, and sometimes they come off, sometimes they don't, but it's just all about practice. And when you can get really good, you can start building shots while talking to your audience and sending them live. It's pretty cool what you can do. It becomes a like a professional TV studio while playing video games, which is pretty awesome in my opinion.
Definitely.
Are you going to get this guy? Is he maybe too small?
No. Oh, he lucked out.
Oh, man.
Did you see that?
He just blew up right now. He's trying to get you, but I think you guys are too similar in size.
Yeah, I don't know why he's trying to get me. It's not going to happen.
And now he understood.
He lucked out. I would have grabbed both of them, but he got right up there against the wall. Yeah.
I'll go get Chica the Chicken.
Oh.
My poker face. My poker face. Big Sale Helper. Oh, you
too slow.
Dude, yeah, you had a hesitation right there, man. That was bad.
I didn't know who to go for.
that
guy's just going to get eaten because he's
hanging
playing,
out.
Yeah.
Go get Alan.
Oh, you guys are too
poker
fast
face
for me.
Is going to get worked. Gosh, this game is so enthralling to me. I know it's so simple, but I just absolutely love it. All right, so these were the independent games. But if you guys were to choose, I don't know if any of you guys watched the Game Awards. It was a couple weeks ago. There's no way you can get that, man.
I know, but I might be able to.
They had a whole bunch of categories. So Game of the Year, Developer of the Year, Best Independent Game, which Rocket League won, clearly, because it just crushed.
That was a great game.
Yeah. Best Mobile Handheld Game, Best Narrative, which is... I bet Heavy Rain probably won that a couple years ago.
That's a pretty old game now, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. That must have won a while back. This year, this thing called Her Story won, which is... it was like written and directed. It's almost like a movie, but then you play it. Kind of like Heavy Rain was. But you use a database of video clips like coming from the police, and you are a detective, and you kind of just have to try and solve the crime. I love those kind of games. But Best Shooter just blew us away. If you guys saw, Battlefield came out, Destiny, Star Wars Battlefront, Call of Duty, Destiny, Halo 5, all of these games came out. And the winner, I don't know if you guys have even heard of this, I had never even heard of it, but the winner of this Best Shooter of the Year was called Splatoon. It was made for Wii. Your little tiny squid guys who shoot their own ink at people to cover them in colors. It won not only Best Shooter, but Best Multiplayer Game as well. That just blows my mind. I love, you have these people spending millions and millions and millions of dollars on these franchises.
And that game wins, yeah.
And this goofy little like cartoon game won Best Shooter and Best Multiplayer. That makes me real happy. Those are the kind of things I live for. Always rooting for the underdog. Kind of like David here.
So I know a lot of people knock on it, but I really like the Assassin's Creed series. I mean, they got a little boring there for a while, I think, but...
What is it that you like about it?
It's like an open adventure game.
No. Look at that. You got real big there for a while, man.
Yeah.
That was good. Time alive. Mm-hmm. Almost 11 minutes. Well done. The main things about game show that appeal to me the most are the recording abilities, transitions, and replays. Hoping to do my first game show stream to test the waters as soon as I get my overlay video CLR settings transferred over from OBS. Yeah, I know what you mean. Have you checked out the downloadable templates? Here, let's see if we can pull that up and show people how to do that real fast.
Yeah.
So this is brand new with 1.3.
Let's get that back over there.
And it's a system that is still... Oh, no, it's not.
Yeah, I got this one over here.
Okay. Yeah. It's still like it's in its infant stages. We're looking to do some more things going into the future. But at the moment, you go to gameshow.net. I think you spelled it wrong.
Yeah.
Gameshow.net. Go up there to share and connect. Then we have this here. It says browse and download templates and widgets. So within this, there you can see that there's four templates up there submitted from people. Here, let me take the mouse real
fast.
Go for
it.
I've been using this a lot. So if I go over here, this is Ultra Street Fighter template. I've got a little bouncing eyeball and a little bouncing...
download button.
Here, let's see if we can get my... let's go to screen capture and show my mouse. Show my mouse capture.
Yeah, yeah.
There we go.
Well, you got hit.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it worked.
Send it live.
No, you don't need to if it's a widget.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Nice. So now you can see that this will give you a preview of the template, and then this will give you a download as well. So if I wanted to look at these templates, by the way, these were all uploaded by someone right here. Upload templates and widgets. You just fill this out, put your name in there. The name that you give us is the author name that we'll put on the template.
Yeah.
But you submit that, we'll go through a little quick virus scan, and then just to make sure there's nothing inappropriate in it, both on the physical and on the virus side, and then we'll upload it here. So if I wanted a Street Fighter template, I could press this, and now you can see it's cycling through some of the screenshots that are in the game. So here we go. Those are part of it. This is what it's going to look like.
These are screenshots of your different shot layouts and everything.
So it'll come with this little blue frame and the camera in there. Here's another one that's kind of condensed it down. Put the game up in the middle. The classic Street Fighter world map and then two different cameras you can have. And then here's another one. Maybe put your chat here on the right side. So somebody built this template. Looks like Matt over there.
Yeah, Matt, dude.
A friend of ours, Matt. He built this template, uploaded it up, and now you can download it. It comes with all of the elements built in already. So if... use templates, Ethan.
I need to get my chat up here.
Yeah, I'm not sure if I know who Ethan is. Maybe that's a reference going over my head, but...
My laptop died. I got no chat.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Here, take mine. You can't quite do that because it'll unplug.
Oh,
but,
that's fine.
So that's just the Ultimate Street Fighter. So here's one made for Rocket League. If I open this up, you can see that there's some game ideas here. And then once again, there's Matt with his hoodie. So it looks like he made both of these. So now you have your chat and then... He's designed this template to fit with the Rocket League aesthetic. Even comes with a thanks for watching and be right back slide. Yeah. So these things are already built, ready for you guys to use, which is pretty functional. And all you have to do to download it is just come here, click download. It'll download here in the bottom. Looks like it's be done in 1 second.
Mm-hmm. Nope, you downloaded it twice.
Can't quite see it there. It's right behind me. But if you open it up, it comes as a .gameshow template file.
So you'll see that right here, it just popped in. Oh, let me.
Yeah,
you'll
pull it
see
over.
That right here. It just popped under the use a template section right here, right? So we got the custom template section and then the ones that are packaged in with the program. So right here, if I go ahead and open this, let's see, we won't be able to capture that one.
Yeah, we don't have that game running, but.
Yeah. Well, we're already capturing it over there with game process, so I'm going to actually do capture card.
It'll just come up as an unseen
thing,
and then we can just show what
too.
It looks like.
And then hit next. I just didn't want to mess up our game capture.
I understand.
Yeah. All right. So this is...
There it is.
That template.
So it's got your images on top. It looks like you put it there for the intro, the outro, and the standby. And then you've got shot one, which I think is just the game.
So this is intro, outro, standby.
And to be right back.
And then we got like slot
one. Oh, you
got
to clear off the top layer.
That's got just game only. I don't have anything plugged into the Elgato card, so it's just showing no signal. And then we would have the game with a little top kind of bar up there. You can put names if you're doing two player. That'd be cool.
Yeah. We should play some Street Fighter. We played the other week, but a new Street Fighter would be awesome.
Yeah, a new one, yeah.
I'll be quiet now. You don't have to be quiet. Did you see that, though? Wait, go back. We saw her in that. So that's he's already loaded that chat in. You can see right up there that Subsist Cyber.
It pulled the chat right in automatically just by loading the template.
So it's already in there. So you don't have to set any of that stuff up if the person who created the template has already dialed it in for you.
Yeah. And so you know what's really cool is we're doing all this while we're actually streaming on a different monitor with the same game show.
That's wild. We've got multiple instances of monitors, multiple instances of game show, all kinds of stuff going on here.
But we are using only one computer, so that with all this stuff going on, our CPU usage is getting a little high there. But that's what happens when you run, when you're running a full 3D game, two instances of game show. We got like, you know, Agario going and another one, all kinds of stuff.
Are there any plans to add an editing function directly within game show? Might appeal greatly to your YouTube crowd that can't afford Vegas Adobe. That would also add value to the monthly subscription, I'm sure.
That would be really cool. It's definitely something that if we did, we would maybe have like a pro level or something.
Yeah. I think one of the things, the way that I see this program is that it allows you to edit on the fly. So once you get really comfortable with it, you can be doing your things, changing your shots, going between stuff, and it, of course it's not going to give you like full-on editing like an Adobe Premiere or a Vegas or something like that, but you can, it's not just going to give you one static shot that you can never do anything with. You can build into your template these different shots, switch between them, zoom in on your face, these kind of things you can do within it.
Yeah.
But maybe, I mean, that could be interesting. We also make another program, ScreenFlow, but that's for Mac users only, unfortunately.
Yep.
Maybe in the future we can switch over to Windows, but that's a pretty sweet editing program. If you guys haven't seen that, check it out. Dude, I use it all the time. It's so...
I've thought about getting a Mac just to edit like GoPro videos on ScreenFlow.
Dude, it's so intuitive. Nice. It's so easy. I love it. And then there's another question. Templates free or will they also be monetized? So...
On our website, we're not going to monetize them, and we have no plans to currently. I don't foresee that changing in the near future. Mm-hmm. But you know, anybody could monetize the files on their own website and provide them for a fee or make them. So, say if you were a graphic artist and you wanted to make up this really cool template, you know, really cool overlays, you know, you could charge to give the file to somebody if you wanted to, instead of posting it to our site.
Yeah. So. I see two different ways of going about this. You've got users who want to use templates, and they can either go to our website and see whatever people have uploaded, just kind of like open source upload templates. You download it, you tweak it however you want, or you can go in and hire somebody, maybe an artist, to create a template for you within Game Show. And then they just send it over to you and it's ready to go. No work on your part. You just give them a little feedback as to what you're looking for.
Load in your cameras real quick and you're good to go.
And so also these artists can then create their own templates and host them somewhere else if they'd like. But the idea is to be able to have some sort of go between both between the end user and the people making those templates. And so it should be really easy now with this ability to download a template and open it up and have it ready to go within your game show. App. So
Plans for something like desktop presenter for Wirecast. We definitely don't have any plans for because I'm assuming you're referring to remote desktop presenter rather than local desktop presenter. Because you can already do window or monitor capture within Game Show. So that would only be useful bringing in desktops on other machines in. And, you know, that might be something we could do, but just to kind of give some tech information on that, it would not be a replacement for a capture card if you wanted to kind of like bring in a video game from another machine. The performance level and hit on that would just not be equivalent and quality-wise to a capture card, so...
Oh. Don't apologize, Game Speaker. Totally acceptable. It's it's no longer called Desktop Presenter within this, but yeah, it's already there. It's just the screen capture properties. I saw that on the screen. It's just the screen capture that's happening there.
Well, we have in Wirecast, we have Remote Desktop Presenter.
Yeah,
so you can run it on like another machine on your network, and then pick up that desktop and that screen into a remote machine.
So yeah, now it's just at the top here. You just open up a new thing, screen capture. And you can see here it's pulling in our game feed, so I can just say, okay, I like that. That looks good. And now we've got this. Let's make it a little bit smaller. Scale to fit.
Yeah.
There you go. So it's that simple. Now that's Desktop Presenter, more or less, but you get some latency. Do we?
Not from the one that's built into Game Show. There's like zero latency on
there. I'm getting no latency. Yeah, actually, when we were playing earlier, Bryce was looking up there, and I was looking down here on the Desktop Presenter feed within Game Show, and I still won.
Well, with Remote Desktop Presenter, if you're doing it from a remote machine, yeah, you will get a little latency. Probably about the equivalent to... Actually, probably better than a USB capture card. But maybe a USB 3 capture card, about the equivalent of that, where it's there's just, you know, like a half second delay or something.
But video delay and audio delay, would that save us in that situation?
Say that again?
Video delay and audio delay. If we could maybe delay some of the other sources,
yeah, would that not quite work? It would work if you aren't monitoring your your preview window or live window for what you're doing, like your game you're playing, then yeah, you could delay everything up to match each other.
Okay. Locally it rocks?
Yeah, the local Desktop completely. Presenter, it's great. Yeah.
That's what just allowed me to win. Should we play another game real fast?
Yeah, let's go back to, let's close this document that we're using here, because this isn't actually even the document we're streaming from.
Whoa, how did you just close everything?
I always forget about that. So Windows 10, actually I think 8 does it too, but if you grab a window and wiggle it, everything either like minimizes and disappears and stuff. Yeah, it always gets me.
Dude, that's one thing about Windows over Macs that I really like. I love that you can like split both things and have them like equally take up each side of the screen.
Yeah.
Or do something like that. I actually had a dream that I could do that on my Mac. I was really excited.
So Windows 10 has that new cool stuff where it's you got like all three. If you got like two monitors, you can actually do snapping to the inside of the monitors instead of only the outside edges too, like in Windows 8. It's pretty cool.
Interesting.
But enough about that. I think it's time to
play some games.
Yeah, have a little rematch.
Alright, let's do a different one. Capture the Flag's cool, but I just kind of want... Let's see if we can get some bots in there. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I'm just looking for the one that's full screen, because the game does that weird, like, resolution change when you do split screen for some reason.
Well, it's blinking on us. I think it's okay.
Nah, it's fine.
Cool.
Blinky, blinky.
Alright, set up a game here.
Let me close some of this other stuff we've got going on here.
So we're going to play a quick game here, guys. Then we're going to probably do a giveaway. And then we'll probably sign off, because Bryce informed me he has to go to the store.
Yeah, at 3:30 I'm taking off. I got to go to head to the store. And, you know, those usual, you know, things you got to do, right?
Life, man. Yeah. Life. I'm out of salt. So.
You're out of salt?
Yeah. Dude, I've been eating this Malden salt, it's called. It's like flake salt from England. It's incredible.
That's way too fancy.
Dude, I'm not even kidding. Like, I will eat flakes of salt because it's so good. You got to go cook dinner. I'm thinking about dinner right now, Game Speaker. I know what you mean. I know what you mean. I hope you have some nice salt to put on your dinner. Set up this game. Let's go.
Okay. So, set up game. We want to do change game mode. What do we want? We want
Death or free for all sounds good.
Sounds good to me. I just focus on the shooting.
Yeah, let's see if we can get multiple.
Let's do it. Can we, different kind of map, because I don't.
You didn't like that?
Well, we already know where everything is. I guess we could do it.
I don't know. Let's do a different one. Let's do Redwood. Maybe that's Redwood? In Northern California.
Oh, dude, it's
like the speeders level.
Yeah. Okay, so set up bots. I did this before. I added 6 bots, right? And it's good to go. And
bot difficulty, and now you just
edit game. Okay, well, we'll see what happens. How about
that? Hopefully, it's not just you against me, because Well, actually, I'm actually kind of good at this game these days.
Yeah, you had the little flag distraction in there, though.
So, oh, it was the flag's fault.
That's all it was, you know?
I get it. All right, all right. Yeah. I think that's just excuses, my friend. Oh, man, I think it is just one-on-one.
We'll find out.
Well, I mean, wouldn't there be other people in this?
Bots? I don't know if they would do that. We'll
Guys,
see.
How do we add people? We want to shoot some other people.
Oh, check it out. Oh, look at that. We got a little transparency on our followers over there, taking up half the screen.
Oh, I love it.
Da, 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 da.
Eliminate other players.
Oh, man. Oh, so you're looking at this so we can...
Yeah, man, because I can see it.
Yeah, our projector's a little too far away. We need to back it up so we can see more on the screen or see it bigger.
Oh, I can use that jetpack to, like, fly around.
How are you jetpacking? He's on. I'm not telling you.
Why
no, there's
you?
Bots, dude.
Oh, there are?
There's bots, yeah. I just got good. I just got destroyed by a bot.
Even seen.
Game speaker, what are you gonna cook for dinner? I'm hungry, can you tell?
Yeah, dude, that's why you're going to the store.
I know. Cringer63, thanks for following. Appreciate it.
Oh, I got rocked. Got rocked. Cringer, you said?
Yeah, Cringer63 added a follow.
Yeah, I had to cringe a little bit because of how bad that move was right there.
Yeah, that's why he added us.
He was like, oh, you guys suck.
Dude, this bot keeps running from me. I'm trying to hunt him down, but he's running so fast.
Oh, no. I'm pretty sure I just killed myself. This is kind of like Ewok Village here.
I cannot see the people. Game speaker's now following.
Oh, we were more important than dinner.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He's making tacos. Oh. There you go. Any advice on game shows chroma key settings? I have a lighting kit with chroma paint and couldn't quite get it looking as clean as my current client. Well, a lot of it's dependent on lighting. I mean, really, it's just lighting with chroma key. So if it's very too much variance in the color of it, it's not gonna chroma it out. We have just like a kind of a weird little thing behind us, like, what do you call that? Like a little.
It's just like a little green sheet, stretchy sheet that mm-hmm. hangs behind us.
Yeah, and then we just have some lights pointed towards it, lighting it up. And one of the things that I like to stress is that you need to sit kind of far away from it if you can, because otherwise you put a shadow on there, and when you put the shadow on there, it makes it a little harder. The other thing is to use that color picker. And if you just click and hold and drag around on the green area that you want to key out and see where you get like the most of it keyed out,
yeah.
Then bump up your key threshold. That's usually the quickest, easiest way to get something going.
So how does it look in terms of, like if you were to base it off of the key that we have going on, like here's my movement here, you can see me, we're sitting in front of a green screen. Is it looking worse, on par? What are you thinking?
So like if I go all the way back here, does it mess up at all?
Maybe a little bit. Yeah, it looks. Oh no! Oh, I was looking at you and not this. Yeah, this machine.
I'm not paying enough attention to do well.
Come on, man! Aren't you a pro?
Not at Call of Duty. I don't think I should go that way. And it's like I feel like I'm playing on a 7-inch screen because it's easier to look in the preview of Game Show than it is all the way at that.
Yeah, you might be right with that.
All the way
inch.
Over at that.
Three-way lighting kit. Looks great currently, but when I tried it in Game Show, it doesn't quite look right. You know what I would be really cool, Silent Sentry, is if you could...
send us a video.
Yeah, send us a video or even just a screen capture of what it looks like, both in your current setup and then when you try it within Game Show. And let us see if we can see the difference that you're talking about and then see if we can try and figure something out. One of my future goals is to... rethink the chroma keying and just get it like even more robust.
I want to add, personally, I would like to see a color key added to it, not just chroma key.
Mm-hmm.
And then add some more, customizability and more fine tuning on that, with the chroma key that we do have.
How many kills do you have?
I don't know.
I've got zero. Oh, jeez. I'm so bad at this. The guy's, of course, he's got like a way better gun than me. Come on.
Change your gun.
Oh my god.
Dun dun dun.
What is this thing? I don't even know what this is, but I'm gonna rock some people with it. Like some sort of a weird rocket launcher.
Dude, you're just gonna get blown up walking around with that thing. You're gonna blow yourself up. It'll be great.
Bet I could do that. Dude, I can't even like see people.
I know. I just Ooh, gotcha.
Nice.
Oop. I saw you over there.
Saw me?
No, somebody.
Oh, I almost got him. He was in my sights, man.
Oh. Come on. He moved.
Oh, my overdrive is ready. Going so fast.
Your overdrive is ready?
I'm going to sneak up behind this guy and stab him.
Oh.
Oh, no.
That guy waited for me to go all the way around.
Oh, I shot him at least. Headphones are metal, so they reflect slightly. Also, my chair is green fabric to cover it out, but it's not quite the same color as my wall. I have to turn the threshold up to get the chair and the wall. Doing so results in transparency. Ah.
Yeah.
So you've got two different colors that you're keying out. That makes things a little bit more difficult.
Yeah.
I wonder...
Well, I don't know if we have a solution for that right now, unfortunately. I'm sorry to say.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean that we can't think about one. I like the challenge, to tell you the truth.
Yeah.
Where'd that guy go?
And as always, we always encourage you guys, if you have feature suggestions or difficulty with an existing feature, please post it on the forums. That's the best way for us to kind of like manage the request and see what the most popular ones are and which ones to address first.
Yeah. I'm chasing this guy, but he's just cruising, man. He's way faster than me.
Well, I want to turn on, I found out there is a voting feature for the our forums. I want to get that turned on.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, I just shot you. That was me.
I can't even play this game. Not the biggest deal. I probably need to mess with the webcam's properties a little bit more. That would mess up my current settings, though.
No.
Yeah, I would test it out. So you're able to do two different colors keyed out with your current setup? Is that what I'm understanding here?
Yeah, he might be using a color key and something else.
Mm-hmm.
I say something else because I don't want to utter the name.
So guys, here in a couple minutes, we're going to be giving away a three month subscription. But you have to have been active in the chat. Whoa, get kill you. Yes, I got him. Yes, with a nose breaker. Comebacker.
Did you melee him?
Yeah, meleeed him. That's pretty much the only way I can kill people these days.
I always forget about that. Whoop.
Maybe I should just rocket launch them in the face. Maybe I'll just go for a quick swim.
Did we get him, or did he run like circles around me?
Yeah, I'm swimming. Check it out.
You're swimming? I... You can swim in this
You
one,
can
huh?
shoot underwater, too. Bad. Apparently, I've got like unlimited breath, too.
Apparently, you can run forever in this game, too. These characters in this game are in excellent shape if they can run this long.
Dude, I can run that long. No problem. It's just the settings available to allow for a better threshold. I do set it for green, 225 currently, rather than using color select. Ah, okay.
Well, is it about time to...
yeah, I think so. What time
are
we looking at? 328? All right, guys, here's the deal. If you don't talk in the chat in the next 2 minutes...
Hey, guys, there's an ant on me.
Oh, how cute.
Where'd it go?
Let us know you're here. Otherwise, you guys might be out of luck when it comes to getting a free thing here.
Oh, there it is. Get off me.
Just give him a little flick. There you go.
All right, you getting that roll ready?
Yeah, I'm trying. What? Nightbot just kicked me out.
Nightbot kicked you out of our own? That's not very nice.
Kicked itself out, I guess.
Okay.
Ah, we apologize for the ever-decreasing stability of Nightbot. Yeah. I understand that.
Oh. I am not a Call of Duty person. Or at least something. I need a screen I can see. We need to work on that.
You need a bigger screen, is that what you're saying?
Yes. Always.
Always. All right, guys, here we go. Can't wait any longer. Who won last week?
Wasn't that something Wolf? No, Binary Wolf won like two times ago.
Was it Silent Sentry?
Silent Sentry, did you win last time?
Silent Sentry, did you win last week? I don't even remember.
Check your email.
I don't remember.
We have to wait now.
I don't remember what happened there. Is it the 17th? Yes, it was the 10th.
Oh yeah, he says he did. Well, thank you for being honest.
Did I get you your code? For some reason, it's escaping my mind. I hope I did. Yes, Cringer 63. That's how you do it. Yeah. You get aggressive. You get aggressive. Feel free to re-roll. Well, I don't want you to win again, but I still want to get you your other one. So. Let me just make sure you can't win. That's right.
Well, I wonder if Game Speaker's making tacos or if he's still in to win a...
Well, if he's making me a taco, then I think it's a good idea.
Now I might have to make tacos.
All right. We're doing this. Game Show rocks.
Hey, he's
way
back.
To get back, Game Speaker. Here we go. Start giveaway. And the winner is
Game Speaker
with the Game Show Rocks.
Yeah.
Good timing, dude.
Perfect. That's why you won.
You are here and you just won.
Yep.
So, eating goldfish. Wow, you
and,
cooked yourself goldfish for dinner? That is some high quality culinary skill right there.
That was a lot of baking and shaping.
Individual.
What did you use to get the eyes and the little mouth on there?
A stamp, of course. A stamp.
A stamp?
Yeah.
Well, he's making them at home.
Well, he probably created the stamp first.
He got a hunk of rubber and carved it out. That's preparation.
Yeah, that's how you got to do it, man. Why go into something unprepared?
Yep.
Ever. All right, guys, we are going to take off. Be sure to download the 1.3 beta and...
1.3 beta 2.
The second 1.3 beta, just in case you guys are going to YouTube. Mm-hmm. And we will be here not next week, but the week after that. Bryce won't be here, but it'll be another guy that I work with. I'm not sure what we're playing with. I'm leaving that up to him. And then we're trying to get a little four-player... 007 GoldenEye N64 action coming up on January 8th, is next Thursday.
That'll be good.
Thanks you guys for tuning in today. Game Speaker, I will send you a quick little whisper here telling you where to find me. Just like that. And if you guys can send me Silent Sentry, you too. Send me an email. Game Speaker, send me an email. I'll get you guys a 3-month free... 3 months of free game show, and so you can use it whenever you want for 3 months. But thanks everybody for showing up. We will see you guys all in 2 weeks. Happy holidays, and
happy holidays. I won't see you guys.
Have a great time. Peace.
Bye.